everyone, it's Lana from Lana Under Pressure, and in this video, I'm going to be reviewing some do's and don'ts when cooking with your instant Vortex Plus 7-in-1 air fryer. The first do on my list is do make sure you clean the oven and the accessories after every use. Now, it's okay if you don't, you know, get to it right away. I've been guilty of leaving the trays and things for a couple of hours and not cleaning it right after, and that's fine. The most important thing is just to not run the oven again with dirty accessories or not wiping down the oven before you run it again, because then what happens is the food and the grease gets baked in and it makes it much harder to clean off. Now, one of the great things about the Vortex Plus, especially the accessories and the trays, are all of them are very easy to clean. I've been using this since it came out multiple times, almost every single day, and you know, my oven still looks pretty brand new, and so do the trays. The trays are coated, so they're easy to clean. I've just been cleaning them with a sponge with soap and water. You can put all the trays and all the accessories in the dishwasher, and that makes it even easier, but since I've had it, and I've cooked numerous things, different kinds of foods, and I've never put them in the dishwasher. I've just used soap and water, and they've come out perfect. For the accessory, like the basket, a lot of people have asked how you clean that. You can put this in the dishwasher. I haven't, though, and I've cooked chicken in it. I've cooked hot dogs. I've cooked things like French fries, all kinds of things. I've used it multiple times, and the only thing that I use is a little soap and water and this scrub brush. It's like a produce scrub brush that I got at the dollar store. And using this, it's come clean, and you can see it. It looks just almost perfectly brand new. So it's really easy to clean. It's not that hard. For the oven itself, what I use is a Norwex dishcloth, but you can use any dishcloth, and I just use water. I've never even used soap. And you know, you just wipe it down. One thing you have to be careful of is up at the top, there's a little ledge that can be very sharp, and a lot of people have, you know, run their finger across it and cut themselves, so you gotta be very careful. Also, cleaning the knob for the rotisserie, you don't wanna break that, so you really don't need to scrub that down, just again with the dishcloth, just like that on the sides, and it's perfect, comes clean each time. Next on our list is a don't. Don't submerge the door in water. So when you're cleaning the door, one of the great things about the Vortex Plus that, you know, other toaster ovens and air fryers don't have is that you can actually remove the door very easy. And in my video, Beginner's Guide, I show you how to do that. It's really simple. And it's great because then you can really get in the cracks and the crannies to go ahead and clean it. But you have to be careful not to submerge this in water or run it under the sink or put it in the dishwasher. Really, again, all you need to do is take a Norwex cloth and go ahead and wipe it down. If you have some stubborn grease, you know, grease stains, you can do it with a little soap and water, but you have to be careful not to get this really submerged in water, or else water will go ahead and go in between the cracks and you'll have water build up in the door. Now, a lot of people have accidentally gotten water through the door and you can see it because it'll steam up in between, and that's okay. All you need to do is just leave it alone, and once you run the oven a few times, the water will evaporate and it'll be fine. But you definitely don't want to submerge the whole thing or get a lot of water in there. So don't put this in the dishwasher. Don't put it under the sink. Just use a cloth to go ahead and wipe it clean. Next on the list is do always cook with the drip tray at the bottom of the oven. You never want to have anything dripping straight onto the oven floor. You want to make sure you have your drip tray on there. Now, there's one caveat to that, and this is something that I had come up with, is if you are baking or cooking in a dish that won't drip, like if you're cooking a cake or brownies, what you can do is instead of having the drip tray, you can use the slotted tray turned upside down and place that on the bottom. And what that will do is give a little bit of lift so that you have the airflow going up underneath, but it'll keep it as far away from the heating element that's at the top so that it doesn't brown as fast. The next do on the list, talking about trays, is do get creative with how you use and position your trays. The Vortex oven has three positions, lower, middle, and high, in order to place the trays. But really, you can mix and match it and get creative with how you position them in order to get the best cooking for whatever you're making. So for example, I have this 8-inch brownie pan, and in my blog, you can go ahead, I'll put it in the description for a link to the really great and perfect brownies in the Vortex Plus. And I like to use this tray, but on the slotted baking tray, it doesn't fit exactly even using it in the regular way. However, I found that if you flip it upside down and you go ahead and place that in the lower position, that actually gives you more room in order to fit the 8-inch tray. Another tip, and part of the do and getting creative, is you can also use an empty slotted baking tray to put it above in the higher position, just like that. And what that'll do is that'll diffuse the airflow, and it will help your whatever you're baking or air frying, one, not brown as fast, and also if you're doing cupcakes or muffins or cakes, things that are delicate, a lot of times with the air, it'll blow it and it'll kind of make them look topsy-turvy or kind of blow the batter to one side. And this will help diffuse that so that you won't get that and you'll get a nice smooth top. This leads us to our next don't. Don't cook things on the very top position unless you want to broil them quickly. You really need to watch it. You don't want to cook things on the top position, especially foods that splatter or that need a little bit longer, more than a minute or so cooking time. The air fryer fan blows really well, and it's really good at browning things very quickly. And if you put things on the top position, what'll happen is it'll brown way too quick before it gets cooked on the inside. So I recommend either cooking things on the middle and bottom position. Now, if you need to rotate things, so sometimes if you're cooking with two trays, I like to start off on the lower and the middle position, and then halfway through when I flip, once everything's kind of cooked on the inside and just needs to be browned, I'll take the tray on the bottom and move that to the top for a few minutes. But other than that, you really don't want to have things on the very top position because it will overheat and burn really quickly. A really important don't is don't ever place anything on top of the Vortex Plus while it's cooking. The heating element and fan are at the top, and it also has going out through the back, so it's really, really important to make sure you have at least 5 inches of space on the sides, the back, and the top while you're cooking. So if you have it underneath a cabinet and there's not quite enough space, that's okay, just go ahead and move it out from under there while you're cooking. But what will happen is if you have anything on top or it's constricted in any way, it'll start to overheat, and what can happen is it'll either turn off in the middle of cooking or it'll decrease the temperature in order to safely not overheat the oven. The next do on the list is do adjust your time and temperature down when using the air fryer. So whenever cooking anything prepackaged or using a recipe that's meant for the oven, the air fryer is going to cook it a lot faster, and you need a lot less heat to do that. So for example, these sweet potato fries, it says on the prepackaged instruction for the oven to cook them at 425. So in the air fryer, 400 was perfect. Also, it says to cook them a bag for about 20 to 25 minutes, but I found cooking them on the tray only needed 12 minutes. In the rotisserie basket, if you're using that, which I've done for the fries and it works really well, you might need a little bit longer time, but when converting things from an oven to the air fryer, even if you're using the bake or the broil or the air fryer mode, you still want to adjust your temperature down and your time down. So that takes a little getting used to, and again, down in the description, I'll put a link to my blog, and I have a lot of recipes for prepackaged foods and different things where I've converted it from the oven to the Vortex, and that'll help you out. But you're going to have to do a little trial and error to make sure that you're getting the right temperature and the right time. The next don't on my list is really, really important, and that's don't put anything more than 4 pounds on the rotisserie spit or in the basket. It has a 4-pound limit, and this is really, really important. So you may have a chicken that's like 4.2 pounds or 4.3 pounds, and you think, well, you know, no big deal. Don't do it. The housing on there is only meant for 4-pound limit, and so it may cook it. It may cook a 5-pound chicken fine the first time, maybe the second time. You might get away the third or fourth time, but over time it's going to crack that housing, so don't do that. So that doesn't mean that you can't cook a larger chicken or roast in the Vortex. I've done it and it comes out great. The way you're going to do that, though, is you're going to use a baking rack like this that will fit on the bottom above the tray, just like that. Or you can get, they sell pans like this with their own tray, and you can use this on top of the slotted baking rack. I've done it. I've cooked a 6-pound chicken in here, and it was fantastic. It came out just as good. So definitely don't go over that 4-pound limit. Finally, last on the list is do go out and buy one. I highly recommend it. I never really liked air fryers before. I had a basket air fryer and I ended up returning it because I could just never get the hang of it. But with this one, it really has been a time saver. Just with a few modifications on certain recipes, I've been able to cook just about everything, and it's come out absolutely great. I really, really love it, and I think that you will too. So happy cooking, and thanks for watching. Bye.